we can win the victory, and we cannot redeem ourselves from our sins, and we have no price that we can offer. So the battle must be the Lord. Now I want you to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor,
neighbor.
Oh neighbor, don't wait until the battle is over. But you can shout right now. Now put those hands together for Jesus. That I rode all the way from Milton, Delaware, to let somebody know that the battle is not yours, it is the Lord. We are in a season where God is about to bless his people while they are in the middle of the storm. But as I was studying, God told me to tell the people of God to stop trying to fight the battle, because the battle was already won. And so many times, people of God, we try to handle things on our own. But we gotta wait and let God handle the rest. And I feel like preaching in this place. Is it all right if I take the next few minutes and preach like I want to? Now, when we get to the point that I don't care that I don't have any money, when we get to the point that I don't care if I got to ride the church on E, but I'm going to give God some praise. Do I have anybody other than me that has a reason to shout? Do I have anybody other than me that has a reason to praise your God? Then I need you to grab somebody by the hand, and I need you to shake that person's hand like you're going to shake it off. And I need you to say, neighbor, oh neighbor, the battle is not the devil's. Say, neighbor, the battle is not yours. Say, neighbor, the battle is not mine. But say, neighbor, the battle is the Lord. I wish I had some people in here that have been through hell and hot water all week and realizes that if it had not been for Jesus, that was on my side, I could have lost my mind. I could have been on drugs if it had not been for Jesus. I could have been dead, but the God that I serve is more than able. The God that I serve is higher than anybody. Oh my God, we can't let little things get in our way, because as soon as we allow these things to happen, that's when the devil steps his way in. But tonight, God is releasing a fresh anointing of new beginnings. God is releasing a wave of glory right now in the spiritual realm. You got to do, all you got to do is tap into the spiritual realm. I dare you to take the next 30 seconds to tap into the spiritual realm. I dare you to make a personal relationship with God. Oh, come on and worship him, people of God. Stand on your feet and worship him. Oh, my God, I just felt the presence of God move in this place. Oh, come on, young people, we are the next generation. And we cannot be ashamed to serve our God. And we cannot be ashamed to tell our friends about the goodness of God. Oh, come on, tap into the spirit of God. When you tap into the spiritual realm, your blessing is waiting on you. When you tap into the spiritual realm, that's where your deliverance is. He was in a car accident and his car slipped off the road and hit a telephone pole and killed him instantly. And I asked God, I said, God, why is there so many young people dying? And the Spirit of God said, son, because I am coming back soon and I am coming quickly. And young people, don't let this be your last warning. And ready or not, God is coming and we got to be ready. And do I have anybody in here that can stand with me and say, if God comes back right now, I will be ready? Before I take my seat, I wish I had somebody that has one more praise left than you. I wish I had